Hello, everybody, it's the Poltergeist 5000. Welcome back to Paper Mario, and strap yourselves in for a long episode, because I have plans. First of all, I need to actually come back over. Okay, let me just buy, like, a dried shroom or something. Because you can buy dried shrooms here. It's pretty pointless. But hey, here you go, I'll buy a dried shroom. It heals 1 HP and is mostly worthless. I'm not sure you can even cook it. I think you can cook it, but not right now. You have to get an item later that allows you to cook those into fried shrooms. Is this gonna count as three? Okay, yes. You give me many things. You are nice, very nice. My name is Sheik. I've heard an information. Things others do not know. So, nice guy, what would you like to know? How to get to ruins. No. Actually, you want to ask for his favorite food, I think. My favorite food starts with an L and ends with an N. It's a yellow fruit. So sour. Such a nice fragrance. Its trees grow only in the desert oasis outside town. If you were to go to the oasis and get one for me, I might believe you're a true nice guy. For, of course, only the nicest of nice guys can meet Mustafa. If you still seek knowledge, you must give me something more, yes, you understand? That's enough. Well, goodbye.
That's what we need. We need to know that he likes lemons.
Because yes, in the last episode I wasn't sure how you learned that. You just have to give him three things. Da-da-da-da-da. So, in the last episode also, we actually found the oasis. It's down here. One more. I always get confused because I think because I remember the oasis being in the lower right corner, but it's not. It's one up from the lower right corner, which is really confusing. Also, you can't shake the bushes here, and it bothers me. But there is a heart block, which we didn't need, but hey, whatever. Hey, a coin! And this right here, what I cliff hung on last episode, is a super block. With these, you can upgrade one of your party members. Hell yes. So, I'm gonna upgrade Goombario. Because Goombario is going to receive the biggest attack boost from this. Because Goombario's main attack hits twice, when it upgrades, it now hits two for two damage twice, which totals to four. But every other party member we have right now can only do three damage with a single hit. Which is not as good. Okay, there's the lemon. There's also a lime tree over here. Which I would like to pick up too. Cause you can get some pretty nifty stuff. How many 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I want one more. But I'll travel away. Hey, a tasty tonic. Too bad I don't want it. What was I saying? Yeah. So, but, well, I don't know. I don't remember what I was saying, but this is the episode we're gonna spend. Ugh, what a pain in the ass. We are going to spend this episode combing the desert. And that's probably what I'll call this episode, too. Also. This screams a pain in the ass because it's full of bandits, but it's also got a bunch of question mark blocks with cool stuff in them, so it's like, well, dude. Kick ass! Oh, it's Merlee's curse, or what is it called? The spell. It's not a curse, it's a spell. The spell will increase my attack power. Check this shit out. Holy crap, it increases your attack power by 3 for the attack. 8 damage. Now that's incredible. Okay, there's another one. Oh my gosh, are these all coin blocks? Holy shit, there's a couple of hundred of them just up ahead. So good luck. I mean, good luck. This isn't great. I don't super love this, but I'm just gonna use Melty Bounce. Because Goombario now can do 4 damage in a single turn, so he can kill these guys after only one hit, which is great. Fuck. He got my coins. That sound is so funny. It's like, what is that, man? Okay, so I'm just gonna attack. Okay, so I'm gonna jump on this guy back here, and then Goombario can kill the guy with the coin. And then on the next turn, Mario's normal jump
can finish off this, can finish off that guy. Ow. It's a good thing I have all those hot shrooms, because, you know, this is actually kind of dangerous. These enemies will whittle you down, especially if you're combing the whole desert. Thankfully, a lot of these screens just have jack shit on them, so you can, like, skip them by. You know what else, you know what I've always liked about this game? Is, like, its tendency to, when you get into a fight with multiple enemies, like, more than X amount of enemies, it actually increases the star points you get from each enemy by one. Oh, what a pain in the ass. Dude! Am I gonna have to fight that other guy as soon as I get out of this fight? Oh, well, at least it... Actually, I don't think we will level up. Because this guy's getting me two. Well, I guess the second fight might be against more than one bandit. Ah! Oh, what a pain in the freaking ass. Okay. Boing-ree? Well, this isn't gonna be good. There's no way for me to quickly finish this fight. I guess this is the most efficient way I can do it, is just kill them one at a time. Even using FP there wouldn't have been able to... Dang it. Even using FP wouldn't have been able to speed this up, because the most damage Mario can do is 4. You know? We're gonna get a lot of coins doing this, though. Combing the desert like this? This is probably gonna be like a 40-minute episode. It depends on how many fights I get into, I guess. Okay, I think when it comes to HP, I'm doing fine. I want more BP. I'll be upgrading BP a lot until we have the max of 30. But I can want it because I want Quake Hammer, and I also want. I really want Damage Dodge. Nothing around here actually has first strikes, so that's fine. I want that. Payoff. Close call. Close call could be useful. I don't need multi-bounce if I have Quake Hammer. Yeah, and then I can get Damage Dodge. Damage Dodge is really, really good in this game. I mean, it's exactly the same as it is in Paper Mario in the Thousand Year Door, but in the Thousand Year Door, you have super guards that you can use to avoid taking damage at all, which makes the regular guards not nearly as useful. But in this game, you don't have super guards, so... Okay, no, it's not this one. There's a question mark block somewhere. I knew it wasn't that one. The one I'm thinking of is like in the upper left corner of one of these segments. There's a question mark block somewhere around here that you can hit 5 times. I'm not actually sure what it is. It might be like 10 times for a mushroom. 50 times for a super mushroom and 100 times for an ultra shroom. Boom. Beep. Yeah, that Quake Hammer is very good. It'll deal 2 damage to all enemies on the ground. Oh, nice. And it also... Oh, man, I suck so hard at guarding that. Okay, there we go. And it'll also... Well, that's it. It pierces defense, and it hits all grounded enemies for 2 damage, which is better than multi-bounce, that's for damn sure. And it costs the same amount of FP, so, like, what the hell? These Pokies actually have an item that's kind of worth picking up. Oh yeah, I have Dizzy Attack now. Sometimes these Pokies will drop an item called the Dried Fruit. And on top of, like, just having so much flavor, both literally and figuratively... Oh, there's another Attack FX badge. On top of that rock. Equip that right away. Oh, alright, I have 2 more. Okay, so what do we got? Marie, Marie, Marie! And... Ooh! Those are our new Attack FX sounds. That's fun. I'll show what Dizzy Attack does next time we get into a fight we can't avoid. Okay, so here we are at the edge. We've just cleared 1 row and we're up to 9 minutes. Well, a lot of that was getting into those bandit fights earlier on and talking to Sheik. Yeah, just avoid them. It's not so hard to avoid. I mean, like, these areas are big, but they're really spacious, so it's not hard to avoid confrontation. I am worried about inventory space, though. I might have to. I guess it would be a good thing if I ended up eating items to heal myself. That's what I brought them for. You know. eventually going back this way, we'll stumble upon the, it's the blue cactus. What did they say about the blue cactus? Oh, no, blue cactus. If you see blue cactus, get in the Twister. And this will spit us out, if I'm correct, it'll spit us out on top of here where we can get spin attack, which is basically like, okay, now I think we're on the top half, so let me go back. Oh, what's over here? I don't want that stopwatch. Well, I guess I should pick it up. I can use it on a group of four bandits or something. Or just go put it in storage. Poop. Oh, jeez, why did it have to be freaking four of them, man? Good leaf. Boom, bitch! Now we can finish them off with Power Shell. Not super FP efficient, but definitely time efficient, and time is at a premium in this episode, because I have to do the entire episode, or I would have to get my plan on combing this entire desert today. And maybe even revealing the dungeon, which means going through another cutscene back in the outpost. Would you get out of here? Here. This is what Dizzy Attack does. It dizzies the front person, but only for one turn. So what I'm gonna do now is use Shell Toss. And then, I will use one of these Nutty Cakes. I'll use a Nutty Cake. Because I'll get more for refund from a Nutty Cake, I think. Don't quote me on that. Yaw! Yaw! Oh, I don't know if I've pointed it out, but obviously you can see when Cooper hits these guys, or if they throw one of their segments, they actually lose a segment. And I don't think that actually does anything. Like, I don't think, like, it doesn't decrease their power. It basically has functionally no purpose other than when they completely run out of segments. Their head has, like, different attack patterns. It just head bonks you like a Goomba, which is kind of funny. Oh, I'm glad I finished that guy off before I hit this block. Sooner or later, I'm pretty sure... Oh. Oh, that is not where I thought that was at all. Okay. I was totally wrong about that. No, I'm pretty sure I'm out of inventory space. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, no, because I ate one. Yeah, that's right. Of course. Okay, yeah, here's the blue Twister. Okay, so never mind. We are totally fine. In fact, well, apart from that block, I'm not picking up that Tasty Tonic. Tasty Tonics will cure poison, but I'm pretty sure there's nothing in this whole chapter that can actually poison us. It's totally pointless. Also, it'll just take up inventory space, and I'll literally never use it, so... There's that block with the stopwatch. We're now on row 3 from the bottom. It's best to... my advice to you, if you're doing this yourself, is to go along the bottom of each screen, just to make sure you don't miss anything. Anytime you see a block on the ground, it's always best to hit it, like, maybe more than once, or jump on top of it, and then... Or jump on top of it, and then jump again, maybe hit an invisible block. It's worth thinking about. Don't hit the Twister. Unless, maybe that's two down. Well, no, it wouldn't be. Would it? Oh, let's just kill these guys. If it's four, I'll use a stopwatch. Well, that's not four. But it's still such a pain in the ass anyway, because we're gonna have to... You know what, I'm gonna use the stop... No, I'm not. I'll just do this inefficiently. I got damage dodge, what the hell am I so worried about? I must say... I just realized I've been playing off the capture this whole time. Because OBS, the game screen on OBS is so much bigger than the emulator. But because of this game's aesthetic, it looks good even when it's super scaled up. Because it's so, like, fuzzy with such thick outlines. Thickly caked and thickly cucked outlines. Yeah, like, this is pathetic, man. Let's get some enemies to do a little more damage, because I'm not taking any. And I want to. I want this game to kick my ass, because it's more interesting when the game kicks your ass. Remember my Final Fantasy IV LP? The most interesting parts of that whole game were when the game was kicking my... What the hell was that, man? Oh, shit. Well, okay. The most interesting parts of my Final Fantasy IV LP, which, like, nobody watched, because who the hell would? Who the hell wants to watch, like, a 45-part LP? Ooh, Merlovely, I love you! Sorry, I feel like I'm cheating on Merlovely. I mean, it's even worse because they're twins, you know? Mm-hmm. Where's your twin bro, man? Where's your twin bro? Let's just bomb that, just on the off chance that I can get a first strike. Yeah, I knew there was a guy around here somewhere. What? Jeez. He just... Okay. Fuck. Okay, well, that was dumb. I should have known better than to think I would be able... There was any chance of me getting a first strike on a bandit with Bombette, That was never gonna happen. Nice. Very nice. I love it. See, the thing is, like, I could just go, like, super slow. Just take it easy, fight these enemies off one by one, and just guard, and possibly, like, you know, take enough damage that I actually get to use my items. But I want to play aggressively and finish battles quickly and not let them kick my ass too much, because I also want to get this video done in less than an hour, you know? I already slacked on starting this. It's 11:11 right now as I'm saying this, as I'm recording this. So this video is already going to be late because I spent, like, so long reading Awkward Zombie and eating Knot and eating Doritos. Like, dude, what are you doing? Record Paper Mario. I know, you don't want to comb the desert because it's going to be boring and slow and you're not going to, and it's not going to be anything important until, like, the very end. But you got to do it at some point. Another twister. I feel like that guy tipped us. That guy tipped us off about the stone cactus. I forget. I think it was. Was it like? Oh, I don't remember. Well. The good news is we're actually gonna come right up on the entrance to Dry Dry Outpost. As we so here we are at the. No, we're not at the edge yet. Wait. I'm going the wrong way. Oh, for the love of crap! Had I reached the left edge already? I don't remember. But I turned around. I got confused. Shit. Yeah, I was going the wrong way. I remember now going back to the left across all these screens. It's like, no, yeah, I remember going past this, going left. Oh boy. Good thing the speedy spin makes this nice and quick, at least, you know? It's not like we're just traipsing around slow as molasses. Yeah, see, I was at the end. Oh, and here we are back at the main screen. Isn't there a star piece around here? No, you actually get the star piece from Colorado later. Go down to the bottom. We stayed on the path. We stayed on the path yesterday, but we're gonna go along the bottom now just to make sure we're not missing anything. And I'm actually going to go into town to see that tip-off about the stone cactus and if I actually have to worry about it. Because I'm pretty sure the tip-off was, like, south twice and then... Or, like, south three times and then west twice or something. And if it's to the south, well, I've already done the whole bottom half of the desert, so what's the point? I remember my sister really liked this song for some reason. My middle sister, because I have three. Well, yes. Two sisters and one sibling now. What am I gonna say? Where was I gonna go? This guy, right here. I'm not gonna talk to Sheik yet. I'm gonna save that for later. Hey, guess what? Yeah, there's a stone cactus. Yeah, three south and two west. I'll find something special hidden. Yeah. So we didn't really get to use that tip because me combing the desert on the bottom half found it already. I guess what we could do is go talk to Mustafa now. Or Sheik. Sorry, spoilers. Okay. I don't suppose fuck Quizmo's hanging around here. No. Hello. Have a lemon. I know you love them.
Oh, heavenly, a lemon, the nicest of nice things. You have proven you're nice by giving me my favorite thing. And since you're so nice, yes, I'll tell you something really nice. How to see Mustafa. To find Mr. Mustafa, go to the shop in this town. First buy a dried shroom, then buy a dusty hammer.
You must buy them in the correct order, yes? Remember, dried shroom first, and then dusty hammer.
This is a secret sign known only to those loyal to Mustafa. If you buy these things in the correct order, the owner of the shop will let you see Mr. Mustafa. Remember, you must not buy them in the incorrect order.
If you still seek knowledge, you must give me something more. Yes, you understand? No, I gotcha.
I wish you luck in finding Mr. Mustafa, nice guy.
Okay, weirdo. Okay, weirdo. So what was it? Dusty hammer and then a dried shroom? I'm just kidding. Do I have enough room, actually? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, yeah, I totally do, because I just gave him a lemon.
All right, thanks, yeah, totally, okay.
What ho! Buying a dusty hammer after a dried shroom is a secret sign that only friends of Mr. Mustafa know. Because nobody would ever do that by accident. It's totally inconceivable. That means you're with Mr. Aaron with Mustafa. Hey, brother! Good to meet you. Have any questions you need answered?
Oh!
You want to see Mr. Mustafa? He's usually up on the highest part of Jardar Outpost. Just keep going up, my man!
What? Okay. Weirdo. Ooh, the door is ajar! It's like, no, it's not. It's a door. It's not a jar. I wouldn't put jam in it. It's a door. Oh, hey, a letter. Paracarry, you klutz. Who did that say it was to? I wasn't paying attention. Colorado. No. The traveling nomadic mouse on the road. Well, I can handle that.
Oh, you know what else I can do? I can deliver that letter to mouse to freaking Colorado.
Hey, nice guy. We meet again. I'm glad you found me.
Oh my gosh!
I'm Mustafa. I'm the one you've been seeking all this time. When I'm out and about in Jardar Outpost, I use the name Sheik. It's always good to meet a genuinely nice guy. I meet people all the time, but you are by far the nicest guy I've met so far. Your name is Mario, yes? I heard that you want to go to Dry Dry Ruins. I have a feeling you are on an important journey, so I will tell you the secret. Dry Dry Ruins is a very important place. My ancestors have watched over it for many generations. If I do not keep evil folk out of the ruins, who will? You must promise me that you will tell no one this secret. I'll give you this.
You got the Pulse Stone.
Sorry, I'm yawning.
This Pulse Stone is the key to finding Dreaded Ruins. Take it to the desert, yes? The Pulse Stone will flash above your head as you get close to the ruins. The closer you get to the ruins, the faster the Pulse Stone will flash. Follow where it leads you. Find the palace where the Pulse Stone is. Yeah.
Dude, how many times are you going to say the same thing over and over?
Let's tattle him. Here. Let's get out there.
Da 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 da!
No, actually, it's da 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 da! Apparently, it's like.
Oh my gosh, I'm so stupid!
Okay. Why did I say apparently? Like, ugh. Secret revealed his true self. I guess that means he's the boss everyone talks about. Oh, I was imagining Mustafa to look a lot cooler. Judgy! Yikes, okay.
Apparently. What a stupid thing to say after that. It's like, because the whole joke is, oh, ha ha ha, Sheik! Ha 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 ha! It's Sheik! Get it? Like, from Ocarina of Time?
But I mean, da-da-da-dum could mean, like, anything. Like, do you have any idea how many four-note fanfares there are where the fourth one is the most emphasized? Okay, let's switch to Paracarry here and deliver this letter to the traveling nomadic mouse on the road.
If you go southeast from here, you'll reach a beautiful desert oasis where lemon and lime trees grow. It's nice and cool. It's really the best place to have a rest, but many enemies plague the surrounding area.
If you want to reach the oasis in one piece, be careful. Traveling nomadic mouse, correct? You don't have a name or anything. The name's Paracarry. I deliver letters. I believe I have one for you. Hang on a moment. There you go. Here you go. Another letter duly delivered. A postman's job is never done.
A letter to me from Mustafa. I've heard the name, but I can't remember who he is. Anyway, thank you for delivering it. I'm surprised that you found me way out here. It's extremely hot traveling in the desert, so take care. Oh yeah, take this as my thanks. Don't hesitate. Please take it.
You get a star piece! Yay! So happy.
Man, I want to eat some more of those Doritos. They're really good. I tell you what, like, spicy chips are like the best cure for my shitty-ass sinuses. Because they just make it all melt. You know, they make all that sinus fuck melt. And like, yeah, I get the sniffles, but I'd rather have the sniffles and a nose than no nose at all. Okay. Hello.
Hey, old boy. Doing well, I trust? It's barely a morsel, but I finally got a bit of news about Dryder Ruins. This fellow from Dryder Outpost claims that another bloke named Mustafa knows where the Dryder Ruins are. Tragically, only his followers know where You're Colorado, correct? The name's Paracary. I deliver letters.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, there you go.
Oh, good show! It's a letter for my wife. Thank you ever so, old chap. This is just what I needed to give me strength to go on. I know. I'll pass this along as a spot of thanks. I came across it while I was immersed in the dig around here.
You get a star piece! Hooray. Now, let me actually check something. I know there are maps of this place, and I want to know exactly where the ruins are so I can avoid them until the very last... So that I can purposefully make them the last screen I stumble upon. Why do you not have the Dry Dry Ruins on this fucking map? Are you kidding me? Okay, that's what I thought. Okay. So I remember. So I know now. So let's go up from here. And let's actually do something weird. Let's go... Okay, well, let's go all the way to the right first. Oh, here's the block. That block I mentioned before, where you need to hit it like 10 times. Hit it once, and you get a mushroom. Which is like, whatever. I think I'll just eat that right now. Even though I don't really need it. And then... hit it again. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 for a super mushroom. And then hit it. A 100 times for an ultra shroom. What? Okay, let's get rid of the dried shroom. There we go. Probably speed that up and try and put a counter on there. This episode is gonna be so late, holy crap. Okay, anyway. So, there's absolutely nothing on this screen. Wow. There's a block there, but I have no room in my inventory, so I ain't even gonna hit him. Because on the off chance it's actually something important, I'm not gonna be able to pick it up, you know? I guess I could drop the dusty hammer, but... Oh, right here, there's actually a badge here. Jump in the middle of these three palm trees, and you get runaway pay, which lets Mario earn star points even if he escapes from battle. So if you've earned star points already from defeating enemies, you can run away from battle, and you'll keep the star points, which is very nice. I'm just gonna ignore these. I don't really need the coins, I guess. I mean, I shouldn't just be so callous like that, but... who cares? So now, we're on row, what is this, row 6 of, row 6 from the bottom, the penultimate row, we're getting into a fight, why'd it have to be a fight, you know what, no, I don't want to run, because then I'll lose coins, I'll just switch over to fucking, I don't know, I'll switch over to Goombario, well, no, you know what, why switch? I'm gonna use Quake Hammer again anyway. There's a skydive. For your viewing pleasure. Ow. That attack is so tricky to dodge. Because the timing on it, it's so fast. It's fast yet delayed. Sorry if those drinking sounds are nasty. My dad got me this water bottle with one of them spigot style lids for Christmas. It's pretty nice, but might sound gross. So without spoiling what we're gonna find there, the square of the map that this is leading us to is actually which one? Like, see, this always confused me. Like, how do you know which... On chessboards, how do you know which one... If you didn't know... If you weren't already familiar, how would you figure out which one... Which to use letters for and which to use numbers for when it comes to the rows versus the columns? It doesn't make any sense to me. You know? So this is the upper left corner. Nothing really much around here. Some blocks, I probably just have like a single coin in them. Or items I don't want to be toting around. There's one square around here that has like 8 pokies on it. It's like ridiculous. I guess I don't need a Paracarry anymore. I'll switch over to Goo Mario. Did you know that? Can I save water inside? That's the only thing that can survive out here. Oh, I should have like a bonus episode where I go and tattle every single square of this place. That would be hilarious. Okay, so now we can go back up. That's not it. There's a square with more pokies than that. Ugh, excuse me. Nothing? Nothing up here? I see a fire flower in the background. I guess I could... Holy shit. Yeah, this is the screen. There's like a couple of hundred of them. Oh, man. Okay, get rid of the Dusty Hammer. The Dusty Hammer will do 1 damage, but it can do 1 damage to any enemy on screen, even enemies that are out of the reach of a jump attack. Which Paracarry, coincidentally, can also do, which is one of the few things that makes him, like, unironically useful. Okay, this looks like it might just be, like, a bunch of coin blocks. Let me actually fight this guy. We're almost done this episode, guys. Then we can all go home to our wives. Beep! Boop! Yaw! I should have a halls. Where are my halls? Here they are. What the hell was that? Come on. I hate opening ziplocks with one hand. Come on! Seriously? Lock tighter than Alcatraz. How? I guess I'll bonk you. Give me my coins back. This is my best punch! I don't know if any of you have ever seen that bit on Game Grumps where they did, like, here comes the jump kick! Where they, like, say that and then do some stupid shit. But me and a friend from church used to have a similar thing we did on his trampoline when I would go over there and play. Where we would say, this is my best punch! And then we would do some stupid shit with a punch. Like, do, like, a somersault and then face plant while, like, vaguely swinging our arm, you know? Since it was on a trampoline, it was, like, it was fun. But, I don't know. Anyway. So let's take every single block around here and see if there are any of these are coin blocks. Nothing there. No. Hey! Thank you very much for the gift of the balloon. Oh my gosh, this episode is gonna be so boring to watch. It's literally just like the same fucking desert for aeons. Now just don't... Aw, balls. Now, thankfully, most of these pokey fights out here are against, like, 1 or 2 pokies. I think there might be, like, 1-4 pokier, but... It's not really as dangerous as it looks. Dude, get out of the fucking way, man! I'll run away again, I don't care. I got 245 freaking coins, man. And yeah, getting coins is harder in this game than it is in TTYD, because you can't sell the badges you're not using, but... What is it? What do you have to say about this screen? You know what I just realized? I hate the desert. Yep. Sand gets in my eyes, but I can't see. I feel like I've eaten a couple pounds of sand and my feet itch. It's itchy and it gets everywhere. I'm freaking out here. Oh my gosh, that's hilarious. How big is it anyway? I'm beat. My feet hurt. This sand feels like it's 1,000 degrees. Oh, are we here? Here it is. Place the pulse stone. Holy shit. Whoa! Now that's a cool effect. Even today, that still looks really rad. Can you imagine if they made like a... Can you imagine if they remade this game? They'd probably fuck it up. Although the one thing... I guess that like one thing that they haven't fucked up in Paper Mario is that the games still look great. They still look great. So if they just kept all the script and kept everything the same except updated the graphics... It would look amazing, you know? I bet it would look amazing. I feel scary. But, I don't know, maybe not. Maybe because these old graphics definitely have a certain charm to them. I'm just thinking, like, when you look at those effects like that, even though they still look great, I don't know how they managed to make them look so good. But even though they still look great,
There's just something about them. Or, no. Even though they still look great, it would be interesting to see how they could make it look different. It's around ruins. Weren't you totally blown away when it rose out of the sand? That was awesome! I wish we could make it happen again! Yeah, you and me both, but we have to start a whole other playthrough for that. Well, anyway, here's Dry Dry Ruins. So, let's go inside.
I'm the huge, scary Tootin' Koopa, remorseless king of the desert! Who dares set foot in this, my palace of the sands? Speak and be known! Be gone from this place now, or this will befall you!
That was the most annoying voice I could have possibly given that guy. See you next time, guys, when we will tackle the Dry Dry Ruins. Bye!
So very hot. Anyone smell roasting Goomba? Must concentrate. Many dangers in the desert. Keep eyes open. So hot. I feel dizzy. Where are we going again? Who are you anyway? I feel dazed. So thirsty. The cacti seem to be moving. It's the quenchiest.
You know what? Traveling in the desert is really hard. Just moving my feet in the sand is exhausting. I feel like I'm stuck in quicksand. Are we even getting anywhere? Ah, poop. Does it ever rain in a desert like this? I seriously doubt it. Oh boy!
Boom! Oh! Oh!
If there's too little rain, the cacti will dry up. Did you know that? So blue, the desert sky. They gotta call it Big Ol' Super Blue Sky. I think I'm delirious. It's so hot out here, I can't think straight. This looks almost exactly the same as everywhere else. Fine, so there's a few trees growing here. Big deal, I still hate this place. It's scorching, Mario! I'm turning to charcoal! Ah, yes! Some more sand, and some more cacti. How do you stand such a boring landscape? Look, when I signed on for this adventure, I was under the impression there would be some no boredom involved. You know what I just realized? I hate the desert. Yep. Okay, I already saw that one. I'm spent, Mario. No shade, no water, no nothing. I hate this place. It's hot. The desert is hot. I can't imagine people would actually choose to live in a place like this. Don't they get hot? I guess I'm liking hot. All this blowing sand would cover up most paths. I don't even know which direction we're moving. If we find that big path again, let's stick to it so we don't get lost again. Is there nothing here but sand, rocks, and cacti? I guess you should be happy that we're not in a sandstorm. I did see a whirlwind, though. Mario, I'm so tired. If I'm on a shady tree, let's take a rest for a while. Dude. How do trees grow here? When we find a big one, let's take a rest for a while. Is there an echo in here? You wouldn't think that anything could grow out here. These must be a hardy type of tree, huh? We should be near to our outpost. Well, after the endless sands of this desert, it'd be nice to put our feet up in town for a while. You tell that asshole. Just east of here is the desert town of our outpost. We'd better remember how to get back here. Ah, a couple of trees are growing here. It might just be my imagination, but the air feels a bit cooler right here. Just putting one foot in front of another is hard here. Whenever I take a break, I feel like I don't want to move again. In an area like this, it's tough to find things that can serve as landmarks. But that rock in the shape of a cactus is a pretty good one. Traveling through places like this desert really makes you appreciate water. I'm really thirsty right now. Aren't you, Mario? As long as you stick to the path, it's easy to remember how to get a Dry Dry Outpost without getting lost. Since so many people use this path, the desert sands can't cover it up. I think I already read that one. Colorado is searching out mysteries as usual. He seems to be looking for ruins here. The desert is filled with bandits who love to steal coins from travelers. More rocks and sand. It'd be really easy to get lost around here. Aw, fuck. Wow, there's a whole lot of nothing around here. Any idea which direction we should take, Mario? You know, it's smart to take a nap when it gets too hot. That reminds me of something my mom used to say. Take a nap, will you?
Look, it's unbearably hot out. I'm getting pretty fed up with it, if you want to know the truth. Isn't there somewhere we can stop for a rest? Look at that rocky plateau. It looks like it's too high to climb, but I can almost see something good up there. Look, Mario! There's actually some grass growing around here!
Oh, thank heavens! At last, you found an oasis! It's not a mirage, is it? The trees are so green! The water's so blue! Hooray!
Look, Mario! There's actually some grass growing around— Oh, okay. Hey, Mario, are you thirsty at all? I'm parched. Really thirsty. Totally dried up. Wait a minute. My mouth is really dry. Maybe that's why they call it Dry Dry Desert. Oh my god! Okay. Nothing to say about the blue cactuses? There are big cacti around here.
Okay.
The desert wind constantly builds up and tears down the sand dunes. The sand constantly changes, but it pretty much looks the same to me all the time. Cacti also have flowers. Did you know that? I haven't seen any, though. Are you crazy? Do people eat cacti? I actually don't know. You know, there sure are a lot of rocks in the desert. Before I came here, I thought it was just sand, but there are rocks, too. Whoopee.
So hot. So very, very hot. This desert trip. I can't take it anymore!
Hey, Mario, let's find some shade and relax for a while, huh? If we get lost in the desert, we'll dry up and turn into mummies. How about it? Let's rest by that small rock. Maybe there's something unusual about that rock. Mario, aren't you hungry? How about thirsty? Tired? I'm all of those things.
Water. Must have water. I'm so thirsty I could bite a cactus.
Do you think there are any other mysteries in this desert besides the ruins? It'd be nice if we stumbled upon some treasure or something. No matter where we go, all I see is sand. That's what this is like, a sea of sand. And we're lucky we have hats on. We'd probably have come down with sunstroke by now if we hadn't had our hats. But it sure as hell didn't help. Good lord, how many bandits are there in this place?